changing, evolving at times. So you guys made the mission happen, but bounding back successively or alternating, he was just always slightly ahead. To keep someone's targets up, to keep them shooting, to allow the other person to move forward. You guys picked up on that?
Help me!
Calling for fire!
Echo Tango, 3-5-3-5-9-1-5-4.
Blood palpitation?
Yes. Yep.
I'm covering the wound. Back, take off of his shirt, check for any exit wounds.
Take 1, 2, 3. Wagon wheel?
Yeah.
Wagon
wheel.
I'm a 25 uniform, which is a signal support system specialist. And one thing that's really different, or one thing I really like about operating in an SFAB, is being in a 12-man team. And it's a very versatile team. So you have every aspect that you can do as far as the fighting function, from fires, communications, you have your operations. And it's really just there for a 12-man team to get on ground. They can self-sustain, but also provide the support or assist or the liaison between us and our partner forces. For example, Fiji requests an SFAB to come to help stand up their NCO academy and also help train as far as some of their warfighting functions and maneuvering. So we just come in, we alleviate some of that stress off the special forces. We come in and we train up anything from the basic warfighting functions all the way up to our specialty as far as tech, you know, like communications and things in that aspect. Being in a 12-man team, it's more versatile. So that's one thing that I really enjoyed coming to the SFAB. Being a communication advisor, not only do I still get to hone my skills as a communicator, but it also leaves me at a technical advantage when it comes to maneuvering and, you know, the basic warfighting functions.